The Federal Reserve announced it would begin purchasing individual corporate bonds as part of its emergency lending program to inject liquidity into the virus-stricken economy. And the stock market shot up on these news. Free market? What free market? The Fed basically promised to backstop every shitty credit company in America and zombify the US economy. The market is like a drug addict waiting for its next fix of stimulus, tax cut, or rate cut, private profits, and social losses. The Fed has announced they will buy any stock that is down until it is well, not down. Thank you for your understanding. The Fed believes all accounts matter, AAM, and nobody will be allowed to lose on the long side regardless of intellect or lack of effort. So a zombie corporation with flat or declining revenues can now sell its worthless bonds to the Fed, take the freshly created funny money and use it to back shares of its own stock, thus driving up the price. Of course, we all know the Fed isn't involved in goosing to the stock market. The government is buying corporate bonds with our tax money. Let that sink in a minute. The Fed, which according to Goldman Sachs and Citigroup leaks, has said it will do anything to keep the financial markets whole, even as real people suffer, is doing just that. They're buying bad debt from banks and Wall Street. Is anyone buying your debt as you figure out what to do during the pandemic? This is an oligarchy in plain view. Vote out their minions. The Fed is bailing out CEOs and insiders. $50 billion in direct corporate bond purchasing along with purchasing corporate bond ETFs. The Fed Reserve is the only buyer of treasury bonds for the first time in history. And now we have unlimited QE. This is what happened in Japan in 1989. The Nikkei stock market has had a slow bleed for 30 years, and cut in half from its high in October 1989. It actually never recovered from its high in 1989. Ever. We're destined to repeat that mistake. No, humans do not learn from history. Many will lose their money and never get it back. I'm on the sidelines. I don't care if it takes a couple of years to crash, but make no mistake, we're clearly headed there. Of course, the Fed is the only one buying bonds. Who else would lay down billions in this environment, with all this risk, for 2-3%? Let me see if I have this right. 1. Instead of a direct taxpayer handout, the Fed will buy any corporate junk bonds to keep them afloat just so long as it helps prop the stock market up. 2. The Fed doesn't set a target for the stock market but won't let it find true value and also won't let it rise too uncontrollably. 3. We're supposed to believe this is still a free market. It is not surprising that markets will go up every day while the Fed buys up every debt. Accountability for companies is no more. I always wondered how the markets are up this much when last year we didn't have 40 million out of work and the Fed's borrowing and printing daily. Yet markets go up every day with promises, lies, and no fundamentals. What happens when it starts heading down? It would be like an abandoned ship just sailing alone. It is going to be fun watching them jump ship when the bow turns downward. The Fed shouldn't buy corporate bonds at all. The Fed doesn't have any money, they are using money from the Treasury. They're essentially stealing money from our children to prop up their broken system in the present and ensure those already wealthy remain so. This is going to end bad. Real bad. The system is allowing a company that filed for Chapter 11 to issue new shares. That's how corrupt things are right now. Where is the oversight? This isn't part of the Fed's mandate. We're robbing the future generations to backstop the elite. It's criminal. What Fed is doing pumping stock market will result in Costco toilet paper more expensive than the US dollar paper. The Fed is now like the crack the market can't live without. Looks like the market won't test the lows and continue to fly higher. It's very plain and simple, no stimulus big drops while the Main Street begs for money, Wall Street is burping from taxpayers' money. It is okay for Social Security to collapse cheating Americans out of money they have paid in their whole life. But we have an endless supply of taxpayers' money to buy corporate bonds. Just wait till they convert debt to equity. And the government owns airlines, oil, manufacturing, retail department stores. Atlas shrugged. At the end of the day, the Fed owns everything, and we have nothing left but the stock market. The free non-government controlled stock market. Or is this the Zimbabwe stock market? Pump it up, Powell. The 1%ers must remain happy. This is state-sponsored communism of capitalism. There are no free markets anymore, meaning it is not market but a forced bubble upwards by the Fed via BlackRock. it will end so badly for the US. The Costco toilet paper will be more expensive than the US dollar paper. And there you go. This morning before anything opened, the Dow was down over 600 to 700 points due to, whatever you want to put in there. The Fed steps up, pushes a button, imaginary money is printed, and the markets are saved, again. Scam. I wouldn't put a penny in there. Be careful, folks. This fake stock market is being held afloat by the Fed pumping trillions of dollars and keeping interest rates at almost zero. This market is going to crash, and millions will lose their shirts. Only the insiders, aka Congress, and big boys will be safe. When the market crashes, you want a good backup plan, food and water for a start. The Fed, our money is the money used to make more money for the wealthy 1%, it is used to save the market from crushing and to win the elections. In the end, we will have bankrupt companies with record market values, low value US dollar, and the wealthy 1% even wealthier. The Fed is ruling people's lives with their important interest rate decisions and money printing, yet still, people know so little about who they are, how they became so powerful, which banks own them, who are the majority owners of those banks, why the Congress authorized them to print money in the past, which US presidents objected them, why no US institution could audit them except the Congress but never done it. And the media don't help the people with these questions. Some claim it's because the Fed owners own most of the media. There used to be 500 independent news companies in the 70s in the US, now there are only 5 big, which own everything. Welcome back to the Atlantis Report. You are here for your daily dose of the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. The Fed knew the market was about to absolutely melt down again this week, so more printing. One trick pony. A great economy would rebound strongly. It would just resume where it left off, it wouldn't need trillions of dollars to prop it up. It would be nice if the Fed could stay out of the market for more than one day. The Fed's bond buying program looks good on the surface. However, this is why QE can create zombie companies. How do we know if those companies are the virus-stricken companies or the mismanagement-stricken companies way before the outbreak of the virus? I think the Fed should screen out irresponsible mismanaged companies. Let them go bankrupt. The Fed had better inject cash into other urgent places. If the Fed pours money into such zombie companies, we had better make all US companies state-run. As the Fed prints more money, it goes into assets such as stocks, bonds, and real estate. Those with capital get richer. Working-class people who depend on their labor and not on capital get poorer. Donald's elite economy is not the economy of the middle-class American worker. This rewards speculators and destroys savers. We are all being forced to be rampant speculators, rather than prudent savers. Can this really end well? Like a hot potato that gets hotter with time, someone is going to get stuck holding it, and it is not going to be a pleasant ending for anyone, nor end well for the last in line. So retail sales were down a record of 17% in April, but the phony market was rallying huge because the crooked Fed was buying ETFs tied to the S&P, Dow, and NASDAQ. What a con game this is. So much for a free market economy. At least they're telling us they're doing it. I wonder how it is fair for a company that worked to preserve its capital, but now it doesn't get government help and the companies that were run poorly do. Yeah, it makes great sense. Just pay unemployment and let the chips fall how they do. That's the free market for you. Can't begin to imagine how much insiders are going to capitalize on this when they are tipped off on which stocks the Fed is about to purchase. Anyone with half a brain knows it's already happening with the ETFs. I never want to hear again that we are a free market economy, and the US is not a socialist society. The market is moved by the Fed, not by the performance of the companies, an insider from the Fed makes all the money, this is totally illegal. I wonder how it's fair that the taxpayer has no say in which companies are helped and how much they are helped. It's the taxpayer's money. If anyone doubted for one minute that the central banks, which include the Fed, aren't in this together, this should help clarify the situation. The 1% all over the world are having an incredible weenie roast, and the rest of us are the weenies. I wonder if the Fed has taken into account the possibility of massive losses due to bankruptcy. The Fed can pump a year's worth of money into the system. Debt will never replace sales. US companies will just go deeper and deeper into debt, as long as the Fed keeps the money flowing. Can't imagine how this is going to weigh on earnings for the next 5 years, if not longer. Surprised we didn't go to negative rates, like the Japanese. That didn't work either. The market will figure itself out on its own given the chance. Once intervention occurs, it gets worse and worse because there's no more mother of invention to bring on to create new jobs to replace the old ones the government is trying to protect. Federal Reserve Bank creates reserves in the banking system, basically the authorization to lend money. This is essentially an increase in the money supply, and there is no theoretical limit to the amount they can create, but it is inflationary. More money into the same GDP implies it costs more for the same stuff. This flows through as either a systemically higher P/E ratio, if growth offsets the capital creation, or it's inflationary. Arguably, buying bonds removes them from the money supply pool, so it should be neutral, simply a shifting of capital infection from banks to brokers, not that they are terribly isolated, separate. Either way, it probably means a challenging market path to traverse. Hard to imagine this could be precisely managed. So much for the free market. I can understand government intervention to stabilize markets suffering from some type of temporary anomaly. But I haven't heard of any currently associated with bond ETFs. There is no reason for the Fed to buy corporate bonds. This is just about keeping the market up. Let the market fall to where it should be, which is closer to the March lows than current levels. Will markets ever be able to wean off of government intervention? I am sick of hearing, keeping the market up. I think they are doing a lot more than just keeping it up, it's at all-time highs area. This is ridiculous. I keep hearing Powell say Feds are doing what they are doing to support markets so they can function. Why no reporter questions him on this and asks how they used to function before? There are instances in the past when markets corrected 20% or so. If it was a regular business cycle, then why is it different now? Is it that now the top 0.1% are holding the stocks and back then it was the middle class holding stocks? It is surely not because they want to protect jobs, as nothing they have done so far has stopped job losses. Unfortunately, the Fed caves into the barking of the White House. Trump wants a rocket ship, and he will get what he wants. Then it will bomb. The Fed is doing more meddling in elections than the Russians could ever dream of. Seems to me that government intervention is like mixing two substances in a centrifuge. Once the government is in the mix, it will be tough to separate it from these ETFs. Remember, friends, corporations are people too. Taxpayers owe a big debt of gratitude to AT&T for the golden parachute for their retiring CEO. He certainly deserves a life pension of $247,000 per month. Something people fail to understand is that corporate bankruptcy rarely leads to lost jobs. We are literally using taxpayer dollar to prop up high-risk investments and provide golden parachutes for the CEOs. The side effect is that we have a bunch of day traders handing out advice like they are Warren Buffett, while the man himself sits on a stockpile of cash. How long until the US is in Japan's situation where Bank of Japan owns 85% or more of ETFs on their exchange? Look at the Nikkei chart in 1989, it was at 39K, it crashed 75% and then never recovered, even now at 22K, because the Bank of Japan was doing what Fed is doing now, pumping the stock market. Japan went into zombie depression. The same will happen in the US. Americans will hate the Fed and the government. The Fed will be abolished. People will be so poor. More bailing out the rich at the expense of the middle and lower classes. Everything our corrupt government does now is a bailout to the rich. This is called maintaining the status quo. The government's job is to maintain the wealth of existing wealthy people at the cost of the middle class. Vote all the bums out. Democrats and Republicans alike. Find a third-party candidate and send a message. The government helping private companies, isn't that called socialism? This is socialism at its finest. The Fed is state-sponsored communism of capitalism. The US economy is now a centrally managed bureaucracy. The FOMC is unconstitutional and needs to be abolished. The real United States exists in the majority of the lower and middle class. And right now, the majority are hurting. Great swaths of Americans are struggling, with any dream of prosperity a far-off fantasy. And in the meantime, the people who need the least amount of help, the powerful elite who will never worry about having a roof over their head, or where their next meal will come from, are being further enriched on the backs of every American who does have to worry. The word I have in mind is evil. This is pure, unadulterated evil playing out in front of us. I don't care where the money is coming from. Trillions upon trillions of support are being fired at the stock market to prop it up to give the illusion of a strong economy. Imagine if a portion of that were funneled into healthcare, education, poverty. This is evil. And those lucky enough to participate in this Fed-fueled rally are too blinded by greed to see or care. It's time to wake up and ask, when did this country morph into something so grotesque? When did the free market die, and why did we let it happen? Why are we celebrating an elite few siphoning up all the wealth? In the coming years, the rally cry won't be against systemic racism. It will be against the concentration of money and power into the hands of the few. That is where the real battle lies. Now, if only the stock market was related to the average citizen. Unfortunately, this strong market is an indication of a lower standard of living for most citizens. Inflation is apparent to anyone who does their own shopping. A dollar doesn't go as far, and most of us still aren't getting raises equal to inflation. Eventually, they have to stop printing money, and putting it on the taxpayers, coupled with inflation or Wall Street, will be a boom while the rest of us can't pay the bills. This was the Atlantis Report. Please like, share, subscribe, leave me a comment, and please take some time to subscribe to my backup channels. I do upload videos there too. You'll find the links in the description box. You will also find a PayPal link if you want to make a donation. Thank you wholeheartedly to all those of you who have already donated. Stay safe and healthy, friends.